This came to light as the lawmakers interfaced with the URA, led by their Commissioner General John Musingizi, who presented the entity's ministerial policy statement for the financial year 2023-2024. The new target of 29.3 trillion shillings is 400 billion higher than what had been estimated in the budget framework paper.
The total revenue projected is 29.33 trillion. And thank you, Honorable Mar, for that update. That is the most current position. The growth in the financial year 2023-24 is projected at 3.735 trillion.
He was accompanied by the State Minister for Finance in charge of general duties, Henry Musasizi, Rwanda County East MP, who defended the plan, reasoning that this would be realized considering that the entity had invested its manpower and also strengthened most of it.
Majorly contributes to two development plan implementation objectives, which are one, to strengthen budgeting and resource mobilization, two, strengthen the research and evaluation function to better inform planning and plan implementation. The projected URA's resource envelope for financial year 2023-24 is Uganda shillings 619.99 billion as per MTEF projections.
This, however, compelled the majority of the lawmakers on the committee to demand for the strategies that URA management intends to employ to realize the said collections, considering that the entity is struggling to register progress in major collections, such as taxes imposed on hold alone.
Because what URA is providing us up to now is 28.9. So are you saying that you have conceded and you revise for us? These notes you have brought for us.
You work on what the owner of the budget has given you.
But the owner of the budget is going to work through an agency to deliver that output. Mm. And therefore the agency must be committed to collect what the owner is saying, do this.
The budget in the Appropriation Act, the target for revenue collection, tax and non-tax revenue, is 25.5 trillion. I would want to asked already the Commissioner General to provide an update whether this number will be achieved at the end of the financial year, the 25.5 trillion.
Of tax exemptions, and we've seen companies that have got these tax exemptions for the past 20 years, they are being exempted from taxes. So how do you expect our local people to compete with someone who is not paying taxes for years?
But both the line minister, Mr. Musasizi, and the Commissioner General of URA, Mr. Musingizi, insisted that the entity has well-instituted leadership and mechanisms to ably enable the entity to register the desired targets.
My Honorable Minister had answered that question. We are really working hard. We want to try our best in the last 3 months to raise the money that we have been trusted to raise, so we are doing our best to achieve that.
Also derived from our experiences and also the current developments in the industry, among many other options we look at. And next week when I come to present the tax bills,
Mr. Musingizi premised his confidence on the performance registered in the financial year 2021-22, where the overall revenue collections in the financial year 2021-22 were 21.6 trillion shillings against a target of 22.3 trillion shillings. In the current financial year, URA is working on a target of 25 trillion shillings, but only 11.67 trillion was realized as net revenue collections at half year, leaving a deficit of 94.80 billion shillings. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.